good day, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Favi, and welcome to Arrows DIY. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make this lumbar pillow, perfect for a boho aesthetic, maybe even modern farmhouse. Regardless, if you want to make one, I'll show you how for this Chic for Cheek challenge. The host is Christy over at Christy Creates. Christy does lots of DIYs. Amazing. If you haven't checked out Christy, you gotta check her out. I'll leave her link in the description below. At PartOverBarn.com, I saw two of these lumbar pillows for $159. I'm only gonna make one, but definitely not for $80. It's gonna cost us around $6. You're gonna grab two of these rugs from the Dollar Tree, and you're also gonna get two of those yarns. Take one of each color, and you're gonna extend them about 2 feet, 5 times. Basically, you're gonna have about 10 feet, I guess, of yarn, roughly. Just make sure that you have about 10 strings, and then you're going to tie a knot at the end. Then you're going to separate them equally distributed with the colors. Then you're going to braid it loosely. Once the braid is complete, you're going to go ahead and knot it at the other end. You're going to do this 6 times. When you're done with the braid should be about 16 inches. That's the width of our pillow. We're going to go ahead and do this other pattern. This other texture that we're making is basically just 10 strings. Here we're using the white yarn. I've already done this for the white and blue yarn at the bottom. But basically we're just gonna knot all the way through about 1 inch apart. So you should have about 6 to 8 knots. We're not going to be too particular or picky about our knots. It's very rustic in that sense. We're going to go ahead and add a little bit of black paint to this jar of water. And we're just going to put our yarn inside. So you're just going to mix that around until it's all mixed up. Now, once I squeezed it, I noticed it wasn't the proper color. So now I'm gonna have to add more black paint from Apple Barrel and then put it back inside. This time, the color was a lot better. So I set it in this container to dry overnight. Once it was dry, then we can attach it to our pillow. We're gonna take these mats and we're gonna set them upside down. That's right side up for us. So this is what they look like once they were dry, and the white looks gray now. The white yarn looks gray. Now we're gonna turn the rug upside down, and we're going to hot glue these in to cover those little gaps there. After we take the tags off, then we can start hot gluing. You're gonna take the braids that we made first, and you're gonna turn them on their sides, and we're gonna hot glue them on their sides. That way you cannot see the crisscross of the braid. So you're going to extend the braid, pull on it a little bit, and then you're gonna hot glue it. When you hot glue it, be sure that you do not touch the hot glue. So you want to press firmly, but not all the way to the point where you're touching the hot glue. If you touch the hot glue, the yarn starts to get full of hot glue and it will just get messy. We want this to remain looking high end. So when you press down the yarn, try not to press all the way down. I was using my finger protector, but then after some time I chose to use my actual finger. That way I can feel if I'm getting too close to the hot glue. And that would avoid that whole hot glue stringy mess on the yarn. Now we're going to take this other pattern and we're going to attach it with hot glue to the pillow. Since it had the knot pattern, if the string of knots was too short, I was able to cut it at the knot and continue with another piece of knotted yarn string. I hope I'm making sense, but you can see what I'm doing. So now this new piece, I'm gonna add a little ajar. I'm gonna shift that string a little bit over to the left so that the knots are not aligned. Once you get to the end, just cut it off at the knot and hot glue any fraying ends. Now I was gonna do the same thing for this middle part, but then I thought about this and I really like this idea. I took this rug gripper underlay thing from the Dollar Tree, and I took a mop head and I tried to take the strings out of this mop, and I struggled for a really long time. So I cut all that piece out. Then I realized that I could just pull the strings straight out of the mop head, and then life got easier. So I'm going to use this tool, which I've never used before, as you can see, and I'm going to string them through this little rug gripper thing. And using this tool, and it worked perfectly to make the texture we need for the middle of this rug. So what you're going to do is you're just going to feed that mop thread through each one of those squares, but you're not going to pull it all the way through. You're just going to kind of feed it through. I really don't know how to explain it, but you can see hopefully what I'm doing, and I do this all the way down to 16 inches. Then once that was all fed through, I went ahead and I flipped it over, and then I hot glued the other side, that way it stays put. So now I'm just going to speed this up because it's pretty straightforward, but I did want you to see the process of this. I do cut out a lot of it, so you're not going to see a lot of it. But once you feed it through, you're going to go ahead and cut the remainder on the other side. And then you're gonna hot glue that same side. So you're gonna feed it through and then flip it, hot glue it, and cut it. Now, when you wanna add a new piece, what you're gonna do is you're gonna start an inch into the new yarn. That way, you have enough string to keep it in place. Then you're going to skip a whole row and do the same thing again. So we should have three rows at the end of it, with one empty row in between each of those rows. Now we're going to hot glue it to the pillow. So when we hot glue it, we want to put a lot of hot glue. A lot of hot glue, but we're going to do it in maybe 2 inches, 2 inch strips at a time. That way we can really press down every single part of this. Once all of these yarn pieces are laid down, we're going to go ahead and cut the excess off the sides so they don't interfere with the hot glue on the pillow. Now I'm just marking on one pillow, I'm marking 1 inch. 1 inch spacings all around the border of this soon to be pillow. So now we're gonna flip them upside down and we are going to hot glue just that section that I marked off with the marker. So we want to keep the hot glue within that area. So you're just going to line it up and apply the hot glue to that one rug, and then just make sure that all the corners match up. Once you completely attach one side, then we're going to go ahead and cut off the corner about 1 inch from the corner across. That way we're able to make a nice triangle without a bulging corner interfering with a nice clean edge. So if you notice that any of the yarn pieces start coming off for any reason, just go ahead and hot glue them under the yarn. So then again, we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. We're just gonna fold it on that crease, on that mark that we made with the permanent marker. We're just gonna fold it there. I'm sorry guys, it's really late. I'm kind of flustered with my words. I hope you understand what I'm saying, because you definitely see what I mean. But it's amazing how we can do this for $6 instead of paying $80 with just Dollar Tree items. I really, really enjoy making Dollar Tree DIYs, especially high-end dupes. So if that's something you're interested in watching, then you definitely want to subscribe to my channel, because I love making high-end dupes with Dollar Tree items. So you can get the look without paying that much. Now you're just gonna leave a little gap in the corner there, and we're gonna stuff that with some pillow stuffing. Whatever you want to fill it with. You could fill it with polyfill, with actual pillow stuffing. You could fill it with stuffed animals. You could fill it with whatever. Scarves, extra, clutter. Whatever you want to fill it with. Just fill your pillow. And then we're going to hot glue it shut. Be very careful at this last step, because it's so easy to burn yourself. But there you have it. Our cute little pillow for $6 from the Dollar Tree. Crazy, right? Oh my goodness. All right, guys, so look at the final product. Let me know what you think. Did I do a good dupe? We definitely did not pay $80. All right, if you like this video, go ahead and give me a thumbs up. If you don't like it, or if you have any comments, go ahead and leave them down below. I love to hear from you. And if you want to see more of these kind of videos and other things I make in this house, go ahead and subscribe. Join the Arrows DIY family. And I am so, so glad you're here. Thank you so much for watching my video. And until next time, friends, bye.